Hello everyone, and welcome to the White Cherry channel. Today is gonna be a bit of a different video than I usually wanted to post. I usually wanted to post a lot. So far I only have three videos, and sometimes I procrastinate a lot. But anyways, so you can see in the background, I'm just doing a little doodle drawing. I want to make my little character from Final Fantasy XIV into like a little cheap version of itself. Today is gonna be one of those days where I talk about stuff, things that come to mind, and things that comes to politics. Not really politics, but things that will change on YouTube. As you have heard and you have seen, is that the next year, or like within what, 15 more days or so, we're gonna have the COPPA and the CCPA bills that are gonna start affecting most of the YouTubers, as well as this new rule that prevents quote-unquote bullying on YouTube. In other words, you cannot talk bad about any YouTubers anymore, or give them criticism in some mean way. I'm not really sure how it is. I'm barely reading about it. Apparently now you cannot be mean, say bad things to another YouTuber, whether they screwed up or it's like your own opinion, telling them they're idiots or they're just complete morons. But anyways, just to for the beginning, let's start with the COPPA thing. At the beginning of the whole thing, I'm not gonna explain you everything that happened because it's out there. You should read about it and see some of the YouTubers already posting things about it. If not, I'm just gonna leave some links on the description about the COPPA, what is it gonna do, what's gonna happen in more detail. To summarize, what COPPA is gonna do is protect children under the age of 13 and younger from getting their information stolen, or the information be used by any major corporation that wants to, you can say, milk them for money. It's not about rule, but the way that YouTube is trying to quote-unquote help or like proceed to what the FTC wants is that making videos for children or not for children. In simple terms, a YouTuber has to mark either their videos are for children or are they're not targeted to children. And the little thing, the little bot that goes around YouTube scanning all the videos will decide whether this content is for kids and this content is not for kids. Now, keep in mind that I am not a lawyer, I am not anything related to the law, so I have like no degrees or anything, so I will say take it with a grain of salt on the ideas and the things that I will say. I'm not a lawyer, so just, you know, keep in mind that the things that you post on YouTube, you have to be sure that you're posting things that you are under the lines. Anyways, so again, this is like my ideas of what they actually want and my ideas on what it will happen. What the COPPA state is that, well, before we get into that, I am not a lawyer, so anything that I say is just like my ideas, my thoughts, and do not take this as a reference that you can use to say like, oh, I'm free because this guy said this. No, I'm not a lawyer, so make sure you check with a lawyer to make sure your video is not gonna get affected by COPPA. Okay, so close in a nutshell, the COPPA will look for any videos targeted to kids and market them as such. If your video is not targeted for kids, you should be fine. However, the bots, the main reason is a lot of people are concerned is the bots are gonna target certain videos, mostly I will say animations and gaming community, targeting those videos to kids. You may say, well, that's not so bad, it's just gonna decide which one goes for kids and which one goes for adults, which one goes for kids, which one goes for adults. But that's not the problem. The problem is that those videos that they're targeting for kids are gonna be deprived from any or a lot of, they're gonna be deprived from monetization at all. Like, let's say you make a little video about this little character walking around jumping and a lot of kids like it for some flipping reason, and you get hit with the COPPA and you say, okay, my thing is made for kids. For that you should be fine. However, like, comments on the video will be like completely gone. our recommendations will be completely gone, and you will not appear on any recommendations similar to the video that you have posted. So that's like you got 90% of your revenue completely gone from that video. And that is because by doing so, YouTube will not collect any data on that person or child that is watching the video. In the other hand, videos that are targeted by adults are gonna get most of the revenue, most of the stuff. That does not mean that you can go, you know, showing boobies or saying curse words or like putting a lot of like adult themed things. No, not at all, because it will still get demonetized from doing so. So you have to be in this like little gray area where you're not supposed to be neither too childish neither nor too adult oriented. Again, I'm not a lawyer, it's just like something that I think that's what YouTube wants, or this is what I understand from the website of Kappa and for all the videos that I have seen on YouTube talking about this matter. Anyways, so as far as I know, or as far as I understand, again, not a lawyer, is that my understanding is that as long as I have a video that does not involve target to children and does not contain anything too adult thing, I should be okay, quote unquote okay. And I have seen some recent videos that have said that the people from the FTC, the people that created Kappa, said that it's all the matter is in the content. It's like you open a letter, but you're not gonna say, oh, this letter is made for my kid. No, you have to open the letter and read what it says. So I guess it's similar with YouTube videos. You have to see what's on the video to decide, okay, this is for adults or this is for kids. I mean, I can give you a lot of examples, but again, I'm not a lawyer. It's just telling you this is what I do understand, and this is what YouTube and the COPPA and the FTC wants. It's mostly based on the content. And I explicitly say again, I'm not a lawyer. So don't come running back to me saying, oh, he said this, he said that. Okay, that out of the way, just making sure like everybody understands that. The thing is that like a good example you can see is like, oh, let's say the bot goes to this YouTuber channel that has these animation cartoons. They look all childly friendly thing, let's say like a weird SpongeBob thing. And then they start like, oh, ripping apart, cursing, yelling bad jokes, like poop jokes and stuff like that. Of course, it's the bot. The problem with the bots is that, oh, it's cartoonish, it's for kids. No, I guess the thing that YouTube needs to do is optimize those bots so that I can recognize when it's violence, when it's gore, when it's like things that are not meant for kids. But I'm like way out of topic in there now that I think about it. It's just, I guess, in short little terms, to keep this thing simple and short, be careful what you post online nowadays. Like, you cannot post any bad things, you cannot post any bad criticism to anybody in general, whether it is YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, things that misrepresent or like things that make quote-unquote hurt the feelings of the other person. In other words, it's like, oh, YouTube is like throwing all the freedom of speech out the window, like fuck all the speech, screw this. No, you have to put whatever we think is satisfactory for TV. But it's not TV, this is YouTube, this is the internet, a place where you can express yourself whichever flipping way you want. I mean, yes, it is frustrating that you cannot now say, oh, criticism about this guy because his art sucks or something. I don't know what else I can say about that. Is it a good? Is it bad? God, I don't know. I mean, some people being bullied by it. I mean, I do look at the two sides of the story. At one point, yes, you can say like, oh yes, protecting people that are sensitive, that they don't want their feelings hurt, they don't want to do that. But then you're looking on the other side like, okay, so where is the freedom of speech in some way or another? So in other words, you can be on YouTube but you cannot express the how you feel or what the other person makes you feel, or like, oh, this drawing makes me angry because of this reason, or this video, as long as it's like all joy and happy things. I think it's like YouTube got sprayed by the Joker's laughing spray and he cannot take anything negative anymore. Okay, so that's one thing out of the way. Well, that's Kappa. Again, I will repeat this over and over again, I'm not a lawyer, this is what I do understand, and this is my understanding of what the Coppola wants. If I'm wrong or if I'm like completely lunatic, whatever, the comment section is down there. So just say it, tell me about it, poke me. I don't know how that thing works anymore. So that's that. The other thing that I want to talk about is the new California law, the CCPA. I don't know if a lot of people are aware of it, or do they even know about this one. In short terms, this law says that you cannot take any information from people of California that visit your website or a place that is online. That includes like... I don't even own a website, so I don't think this affects me that much. But I guess YouTube is a website, or what the... Also, the FTC thinks is something that they should keep eye on, that is that you have to have this option which tells the user that they can use their information for like commercial purposes, for like selling, retailing. In other words, again, not a lawyer, just explaining the things that I did understand, that I do understand, that is implying to me. In other words, I'm like, this is what I did understand after reading and listening to people talking about it. That doesn't mean that this is something that you should follow as a, like a Bible thing. Okay, so back to what it was. In other words, what it says is that the law requires that you have to have an option somewhere in the website that allows people from California select that they don't want their like any data of them taken from that website and shared with everybody. You know what I'm saying? Like, a good example would be, like, for example, when a few days ago, I went on Google looking for, like, a wrench or, like, a drill, something that my daddy needed to build something around the house. And after, what was it, like, a day or two, after I searched that on my computer, I get little... You know, you go to Facebook and you see those little ads side to side. You see those little ads change from time to time to stuff that you were looking like a few days back. Another place that I have seen that is when I flip through my phone on this app called iFunny. Not sponsored, but it's like a super funny place where I can see a lot of memes and have little funny videos. Not a sponsor, but give me a call, iFunny. From time to time in the app, you will scroll down and you will see this little commercial thing. So they show you like, oh, new games, new that, new things. And I can kid you not that after I search those things on the website on Google, keep in mind, I searched the stuff that my daddy needed on Google, commercials of drills, Home Depot, and other like major companies that sell power tools were popping up in my little iPhone thing. So as you can see, that's something that the law wants to prevent, and I guess that's something similar to COPPA that wants to stop kids getting their information taken and be using for like commercial purposes. I mean, for me it's not bad, but because the law requires that any people from California had that option, or that option has to be on the website, it's not really an inconvenience, but I will say that it's a mandatory thing that has to have in any website. But I guess I can hear most of you saying, yeah, he's not a lawyer, so take this with a grain of salt and with a lot of things. Keep in mind that I'm not a lawyer, and Jesus Christ, what am I emphasizing with that? I'm not a lawyer, because I am not, and I don't want to get screwed over by some idiot saying like, oh, I heard this blah 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 telling me that he knew blah 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 blah. I'm gonna keep a count on how many times I have said this, but again, I am not a lawyer. This is what I did understand about both of these laws. That's a fine period. Put a period in it. Period. That's what I understand. This is not a lawyer say like, oh, this is what he will do and this is what he will have. Okay, slap, slap. Wake up, wake up. Okay, so you can say that, oh, not... There's like no Californian people going to my website to buy or put information about themselves. Technically, you have to, because you never know. Unless it's like you have like some way to block people exclusively from California to go to your website. I'm not sure if this applies for like foreign, out of the state. How do you say, out of the state websites? But probably does. And I don't know. I lost my train of thought on that, but. I mean, for me, I don't have a like exclusive website that I sell or that I require people's information in one way or another. However, YouTube does, or YouTube gets cookies or gets stuff, gets information. And that's the thing that it might affect a people or might affect some people, I guess. I would say mostly big companies that might affect in one way or another. Now, I don't know. It's just the way it is. Or the way how effed up the whole system is. But is it though? I don't know anymore. At any case, that is all the things that I will say about those laws that's coming into YouTube. And into, I guess, every other website that has some sort of way to get people information. And I repeated myself again, I am not a lawyer. I do not know this stuff very well. This is what I did understand. This is what me, little Lily, understand. Alright? That's all I can say. That's the only things that I did understand. This is what they want. And this is what I think, quote unquote, big quotes right there. I think is what they want. Alright. Okay. I'm getting out of my head in here. Anyways, as far as I know, the channel, this channel, the White Cherry channel, well, I will say I will keep trying to continue posting new videos whenever I can. It's not something easy since I have a 12 hour job every day, except for Sundays, which is mostly, the recording right now is on Sunday, of course, because that's the only time I have a few hours to start recording peacefully without having any interruptions or in any sort of way. This is the White Cherry channel created by me, and my little character Lily is the one that you will see on the screen right there. There she is. And I guess my concern is that because my little character is drawn, might attract a bot thinking that, oh, it is made for kids. And the only video I have posted is just me playing, Hollow Knight. I did a little review on the game Genshin Impact because I was invited to the closed beta. That's my concern. And for... and getting sued, but again, reading the laws, it does not say, you know what, let's just forget about that, because again, I say the same thing, do not, I am not a lawyer, okay, I'll come, okay, so, I guess, what I see in the few more days, and on the next few years, I will keep trying this YouTube thing. I will keep trying to do things a little bit different, I guess. I'll try to adjust to the new system. We'll see, because at the very long term, probably might not be a viable platform anymore. Maybe a lot of YouTubers and a lot of people will move to other platforms that does not have this kind of, I will say, kind of BS thing that... most of the YouTubers have seen happening. They change from like, oh, it is for YouTubers. I mean, a good example, you can see what YouTube Rewind was and what it has become now. A lot of people complain about that, and it seems like the complaints has been falling to deaf ears. It's the platform has become mostly oriented to people with money, like it always happened. Like, it's the same thing that the radio, the same thing that the television has fallen into, the same thing will happen to the internet, that all of the stuff will fall into greedy corporations that want to make quick buck, that want to sell their stuff, and that's how the system works, I guess. First thing will be YouTube, the next thing will be probably Twitch if everybody migrates to that. And the next thing will be what? Mixer and so on and so forth. Because as you can see, there's money to be made. And that makes you wonder if a lot of people have that mentality that, oh, new system, new platform, maybe there's money to be made. Everybody's like desperate for money nowadays. But I'm just rambling and babbling a lot of words here and there that makes nothing, makes no sense. It's just a good way to, you know, get the stuff out. I would like to say that my plans for like this whole YouTube channel is to see how it goes, how it grows, how it goes from like one subscriber to 2, 3, 4. At the moment of this record, I don't even know how many subscribers I have. Probably like what, one? And probably it's like my mom or my sister or my brother. I don't even know. And it's kind of like upsetting sometimes knowing that, oh, you're gonna start a YouTube channel, and the first thing that pops up is like, oh, whining about YouTube. Oh my god, what am I doing with my life? Really, I guess work, but then it's a good way to, you know, talk about things. Unless I do some ASMR, which I don't think so. I don't think my voice like compensating for everybody to hear me talking quietly in one way or another. In any case, I will keep trying to draw better. I will try to improve my drawings. I have like so many goals that I want to accomplish by, I guess, next year. Yeah, at the moment of this recording, it's like the 15th of December. Probably when this comes out, will be like the, what was it, the 16th, maybe the 17th. I do not know, but I do know that I'll keep on trying, keep on working, and keep on swimming, keep on swimming. On swimming, and keep going with it. Let's see where does YouTube goes. Will I reach the top? I don't know. Will I end up quitting? Who knows? And as you can see, for the time of the videos uploaded, it's like takes forever. But you know what? It's something that I started to like, started to enjoy. Starting to, you know, feel more accomplished. A way to distress myself in one way or another, either just talking to the microphone, just looking at the little line going up and down as my voice keeps on going, with my headphones on and my mic on the, my mic, how will I say that? When my headphones on, with the mic in the, when, when my headphones are with the mouth in my mic, I will say that I will keep doing this YouTube channel for as long as I can, even though I will not get like anywhere, it is fun to do. It's something that I enjoy doing whenever I can. Interesting, isn't it?
How life turns things around.
But anyways, I think I have been rambling long enough. And again, I will principally say, I am not a lawyer. I'm not a lawyer. Just take all this information, all this that I have showed to you, with a huge bag of salt, and know that all of this thing is my understanding of what the law requires, of what the law wants from us. And it's only my understanding. That does not mean that this is exactly what they want. And I am not a lawyer, so let's keep that rolling. I had to do a count of how many times I have done, like, I am not a lawyer thing. So, as for what I've seen in my time, I'm close to doing some colorings. I'm not gonna finish the whole thing. I'm just gonna end up putting the basic colors on it. I'm not good with this program. I just barely got it. What is it called? Clip Studio Paint. I'm barely starting it because somebody recommended it to me. He said it's a little bit much better than Photoshop, and so far it's been working pretty good. And I still don't understand most of the stuff that is on the on the sheets or the layers, whatever you call it. And probably a lot of you seeing the drawing are screaming on top of your lungs like, what is this guy doing? Why is he putting this and that? Why is he making so many layers? I can just hear you from all the way over here. They're like, no, you should have used this, or you should have done that. Trust me, I'm doing my best to look at some tutorials whenever I can. But you can leave me some links, or like send me like, hey, you should watch this tutorial, it might help you out. Because as you know, drawing is an art, and like, it takes time to get used to it. But it takes time to get better at it. Same thing with every muscle in your body. If you stop using it, it's gone away. So you gotta keep trying, keep drawing, and keep going. Well, I have rambled long enough. For now, I will bid you guys goodbye. And I will see you on the next video. Remember to subscribe. Remember to leave a comment. Remember to leave a like or dislike. Does not matter, as long as you can share what you feel about it. That's all I want to hear from everybody. They share their emotions. That is something that probably YouTube won't allow you to do this unless it's positive. So, anyways, this is Lily from the White Cherry channel, and I will see you on the next video. Bye!